In 2005, I actually received a call from my mom asking me to come. I was in the United States at that time, just started my new job. And she told that my father actually slipped into coma. So I rushed back to India at that time. When I visited India, doctors were actually waiting for me. And they asked me to unplug my father. For 13 days, I actually sat with my father right next to the hospital bed, right next to him in the hospital bed, holding his hand while machines kept him alive. The doctors were very clear to me. They said the brain is dead and there's no chance of recovery. They needed an answer from me. They asked me to pull the plug or keep him alive on a life support system. I am an engineer by design. I solve problems for a living. I build systems that actually take decisions in milliseconds. But there I was paralyzed by the most important decision of my life. And this was my father's life. He's the guy who created me. My family and friends kept asking, what are you going to be doing? The doctors grew impatient. Everyone wanted me to decide. But something in me refused to rush. Maybe it was his hand, and it still felt very warm to me. Maybe it was remembering how he taught me to ride a bike, to throw a curveball, to stand up for what's right and what's wrong. Or maybe it was the terrifying realization that once I said yes, he would be gone forever. And not because I found an answer after 14 days that I let him go, but I honored what the pause gave me. It gave me the time to sit with the weight of love, the time to grieve, the time to remember, the time to become human. 15 years later, my son was born. As I held for him for the first time, something profound clicked. The pause at the hospital wasn't really the weakness that I experienced. It was the most human thing I've ever done in my life. And that's when I realized we were building a world that's forgotten how to pause. Right now, the algorithms in your pocket decide who gets hired, who gets the loan. Where do the packages go? All in milliseconds. There's no hesitation. There's no conscience. We build incredible machines that scream, can we? Million times a day and million times a second, but never whispered to say, should we in the first place? We are not just automating every decision. We are just unbundling and automating our souls for speed and profit. I'm going to ask you to think what exists after this. So I refuse to believe that this is the only way. We asked, what if we build machines that pause, that think, and that feels? Machines that remind us that to be human when we forget the most. This is angelic intelligence, ladies and gentlemen. Intelligence which has conscience. This is not ethical AI, which is do no harm. But this is virtue-based intelligence that amplifies the goodness in you. At its heart is pause protocol. It's very deceptively, very simple. And it asks only three questions. Who does this really help? Who does this harm? And what it takes to be more human? I know that it sounds too soft and touchy-feely for a tech company. But love isn't weakness. Love is the most powerful optimization function that ever existed in this universe. It doesn't just help one person win. It uplifts the entire society around us. This is not just about finding perfect answers. It's about being deliberate with our questions, because sometimes it's asking the right question that matters more. Most systems race to solve the problems faster than the thought. We built one that feels before it acts. That's angelic intelligence. We tested this in the boring world of logistics. Instead of asking how do we move things faster and cheaper that most supply chain guys usually are asked, our system asked, how do we make hope move and deliver good, not just goods? The results were outstanding. We were able to move 2.3 million pounds of food destined to landfills, and we send it to the hungry families. We rush the medicines to the communities the world has once forgotten. This wasn't done at like exponential cost, but it was done at a cost that was like significantly much, much cheaper than the world pays today to move things around. And what we were able to prove is that profit and intent are never at odds when you try to do it at the first principle level. We asked, what if the smartest thing an AI could ever do is remember why we exist in the first place? Remember the human hands and the heart that built it. We also realized we can't patch the conscious onto the existing systems. We had to build it from within. Values first, speed next. Humanity and virtues at the core, not as an afterthought or a safeguard. I want the future to be aimed at benevolent superintelligence, not artificial superintelligence. We needed to start building systems with a soul. There's nothing great about being artificial. There's always something beautiful about being angelic. And that's what we're building. We have a choice. Build artificial intelligence that's fast and that's heartless, or moral machines that are very thoughtful and very human. My dad never met my son, but in those 13 days, the 13 days that was really a torture for me, taught me the most important lesson of my life. Love is worth the pause. Some decisions can't be rushed. I'm not asking you to slow down, ladies and gentlemen. I'm asking you to aim right. Here's what I'm asking you to do. If you're designing a system, are you building an answer engine or are you building a conscious machine? If you lead people, are you really optimizing for profits or for purpose? And before you make any choice that touches any number of people out there, pause and ask, what would an angel do right here, right now? That pause that saved my humanity might be the key to saving all of you guys. The question isn't whether we can build machines with a soul. The question is whether we have the courage to try. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.